I mentor them. I have some who have gone to law school, and I'll tell a quick story. There was a young man who went to law school. He fought really hard, and I took him on a mentorship under my wings in my office. And we would meet, we would talk, and he was bright and he worked hard. And then he was going to graduate. In lawyer's term, we call it call to the bar, not that bar, but the legal bar. And he asked me something. He says, "Will you come and be my representative at my call to the bar? Will you come and be my family? Because I have no other family to come with me." That broke my heart. Needless to say, I went. And it was a very proud day because I had this much to do with him getting there. He did all the rest. But it was a proud day because I was able to participate and share and be there for him. And if you've ever gone to a call to the bar, there's about 1,100 people, young lawyers being called. And it's in the Roy Thompson Hall. And it's huge, and I'm way up there. And I remember seeing him standing up and waving. And I had to stand up and wave so he knew that I was in fact there. And that's the kind of mentorship we talk about. That's the kind of mentorship that Dudley told me to remember. So, you have to know that if you have, or young people have, any issues in regards to policing and conduct issues, you go to my office. It's the OIPRD. You file a complaint. We look at it. We look at it in a very natural and unbiased manner. But enough about my organization. We're here today to celebrate 30 years of excellence of work by BADC. We all know that the work is still unfinished. And Akua put it so nicely. We have lots of ways and a long way to go. The road ahead still needs to be walked. And we all must stay strong. We must never accept the status quo. While we work, and while the work continues with new faces, new methods, as Mandela said, it's a challenging job to bring about positive change, especially when it involves differential treatment of people. But you know that. And the people you're going to recognize today, Kingsley, Nancy, and Oliver, they know that. You and the others know that. And many of you who participated in the creation of the formation of BADC in 1988 know that. It didn't stop you then, and I can tell you, it wouldn't stop me now, and it wouldn't stop all the millennials who are going to come after us, because there are young ones who are picking up the struggle, and young ones who are picking up the mantle. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, of course, Mr. Jerry McNeely. Jerry, an amazing message. Now, don't go anywhere. I know you're trying to escape. Don't worry, I'm not going to make you sing again, all right? But we have a very special presentation to be made to you, sir, by the president of BADC, Mr. Hewitt Logie, who I know is around here somewhere.
He's coming.
He's coming. All right, so we do have something in time. So, you know, here's what we're going to do. Love theme international, international. Read them all. No, I'm playing. I'm joking. Put you on the spot, right? Because you didn't.
Hey, baby.
I want to present it. Oh, no. It's okay. It's coming. Thank you, my sister. Jerry, on behalf of the Black Action Defense Committee, I want to thank you so much for accepting an invitation to come and address BADC's gathering this afternoon. And we'd like to present this token of appreciation to you. And it says, Partnership Award presented to Jerry McNeely in appreciation of your keynote address at our Dudley Laws Fundraising Scholarship Run, May 6, 2018.
And if we could have already taken these pictures, if I might be so bold to suggest that, could be, we have the original founding members of BADC here. Could you come to the stage too and jump into this picture? Could we do that? The founding members of BADC. Yes, I know you move a little slower than you might have back when you found it.
I'm going to take the mic from him because I know who you are. So please make your way to the stage before I start calling out your names.
We know where you live, Norman. Original founding members of BADC, if you want to get up in this way, we just want to acknowledge you, if you would give us that privilege, please.
And then, because people are very cognizant of who the original BADC members are, the BADC members, they might not be founding members, but BADC members, please come on up and take your place here. You will know that this is many generations, because obviously the organization is celebrating some 30 years. So I know I saw some of you look around like, well, I'm not a founding member, but you're a member, we acknowledge you, please come on up.
I'm not founding, I'm not a founding member, but you know.
We introduce to you Sister Doctor Benjamin, Akua Benjamin, Brother Hewitt Lowe, Brother Logley, Brother Logie, Ms. Mary Alcindor, Ms. Sonia Brown, Mr. Freckleton, Ms. Joyce Ewers, Ms. Mabuyu Hyman, Mr. Kingsley Gilliam, Ms. Valerie Steele, Mr. Kwabena Feu, did I miss anybody? And to all the BADC supporters, we thank you. Please give them a warm round of applause.
Without your support, this afternoon's event would not be possible. Progressive Movements, of course, Master Chefman Dan Williamson, sales representative with Home Life, the Home Life Foundation, Active Rehabilitation and Chiropractic Center, Henry's Records, Lugie's International Disc Jockey Services, as well as the Labor Toronto and York Regional Council since 1871, the USW Local 1998, and every one of you that are here to celebrate the legacy and, of course, the contributions of Dudley Laws and the BADC Foundation. And we have another performance for you, of course, ladies and gentlemen. Please give a round of applause to Ms. Nando Hyman.
Congratulations once again to 30 years of BADC. We know that I'm reminded of the words of that great African-American educator, Dr. Marva Collins, who says, excellence is not an act, it's a habit. And so the things we do the most are the things we do the best. And so if there was not habitual excellence, we could not stand here some 30 years to appreciate, to recognize, and to celebrate the recipients of today's awards. Give them a round of applause. Now, there's many There was many conversations about the history of people, and as we think about those who were BADC members who've gone on, Sister Monifa Owusu, Mr. Dudley Laws, Brother Charlie Roach, Mr. Ed Clark, Milton Blake, Colin Kerr, Shango, Oliver Springer, and last but not least, my father who passed away last year, Mr. Brian Hyman. I wouldn't tell you, and Brother Jack Johnson. I couldn't tell you, if we wouldn't be here today. It is that indomitable spirit that continues everywhere we go, and we know it's that spirit that guides us. And so, you know, I need to clear up a little something. Today I come to sing, but many people ask me, where did she go? So let me clear up a myth, okay? Because people ask me this all the time. By profession, I am a principal. Yes, I was the principal of the Afrocentric School, but I didn't blow off into oblivion. I'm currently a principal. I was a principal before the Afrocentric School, and I'm still a principal now. So that's one thing, all right? The second thing, though, is that African people and the history of us is that we wear many hats. And one of the hats that Brother Dudley Laws always used to have was the gift of music, of singing. And if he were here today, what song would he sing, my people? We always would close every event with that. And the young people who were little at the time would moan and groan. Okay, we know he's gonna call us. By the rivers of Babylon. And he would stand tall, remember? Erect back and sing with power. Does everybody remember that? No, does everybody remember that? And then I thought to myself, look at the recipients. I was the first principal of the Afrocentric School, and I looked over and I saw Ilya, and I thought, my gosh, Ilya, I haven't seen this child since she was in kindergarten. And she got up and she spoke. I didn't know I had anything to do with it. I didn't even know I was included. But how proud are we of our young people? You know, Frank Fanon says that each generation out of relative obscurity must discover its own mission, betray it, or fulfill it. And so, if we don't educate our young people, then our work is for naught. But here I was in the audience, looking at little Ilya, who's grown up, a young woman today, and say, you know what? The work we have done, the work we'll continue to do, despite problems, struggles, challenges, because of out of challenges, that's what Jerry, that you spoke well. I remember working with Jerry when I was a kid too. My gosh, I'm getting up there. But if there is no struggle, there cannot be what? Progress. And so today we salute all of you because we see the young people and we know that our work is not for naught because they will carry on. I am heartened. Please give them another round of applause. And so this song is called Better Days because better days is always coming. Turn it. Turn it. Turn up. And I'm gonna ask you to rewind it and we'll come again, right? I'm used to that. So we know that better days are coming, yes? Yes? All right, always coming. Believe. sing into the mic. They say, what's that? Better days. Come on now. Oh,
Amazing job, guys. Amazing. Thank you. So good.